Hi, this is Alex, and welcome to the Zero to Alpha podcast. Alright, what's up? A new podcast today on a Friday. So most people are probably wondering why I released this podcast on a Friday. Well, the reason is pretty simple. It's my motherfucking birthday, bitches! Yeah, so I decided to work on my birthday. I'm gonna train as well. I'm just gonna enjoy it like every other day. I'm gonna relax though. But I want to do a podcast about a pretty controversial topic. I'm gonna talk about the perspective of loss this time. Because face it, we all hate losing. I hate it. I've never met anyone who likes to lose, but there is something that I realized recently. There is something beautiful in losing. And it doesn't matter if you lose in like competition or relationships, or because if you lose and you learn your lessons, then you're gonna be a better person or better fighter. I'm gonna relate to fighting all the time here, or you know, or a better person in a relationship, or it can save your broken relationship if you learn. But the main thing is that loss is actually a beautiful thing. I think it brings out the best of the of people if they are willing to accept it, of course. And that's the thing, you know, like most people aren't willing to accept a loss. So here's a question for you. Have you ever faced a loss in life? You probably did you? I mean, who hasn't? I lost a lot this year. I mean, in May I entered a grappling tournament. It was a long time ago since I competed. And I was ahead on the scorecards. By the end, I lost 10 minutes before the bell. And it was due to my own mistake. And if I didn't tap out, it was a verbal tap out, because otherwise he would have broken my arm. So I was really frustrated. Well, it went pretty fast. Like, you have the four cycles of loss. So you have denial, frustration, another one, and then you have acceptance. And they filmed that grappling tournament and the match, and you could see me go through the stages pretty easily. Like, it was frustrated because I was like, fuck! I couldn't believe that I lost, but then I accepted pretty quickly. But it sucked though, nonetheless, because I was ahead of on the scorecards. But what does it have to do with the perspective of loss, you ask? Well, I'm gonna take you to a trip inside of my head and how I deal with loss and other things. Because like, the grappling tournament isn't the only thing that I lost. I also have a relationship that didn't work out. That was another bummer, but I got over it. I learned my lessons. It took me like a week or so, you know. I learned my lessons in a week. I accepted right away. I was like, I did this and this wrong, so now I can make my next one work. But anyways, when we face loss, there's something pretty strange that happens. The first thing that people do if you're okay, and then they'll tell you that everything will be fine. Which is kind of true, because you don't know if everything will be fine. I know people who are still like beat up by a heartbreak, like they just can't get over it. I recently heard a story about a woman who divorced her husband 20 years ago, and she's still suffering from that breakup. Pretty weird, right? So when you face a loss, there are two kinds of people. There are the ones who support you and the ones who will mock you. And some will even mock you straight in your face. Some people will celebrate when you face adversity. Like, when I broke my nose this year in sparring, I think it was this year, there were actually people who laughed in my face. But I celebrate with them, because loss is one of the best things that can ever happen to you. You see, some people want to project an absurd image into the world. They want to be seen as only perfect, only tough. They want to be like they have a sense. They're delusional, like in some kind of way, because if you're perfect, you can't lose. So they will share all their highs in life, but they'll never share their lows, because they're not supposed to have those lows, but they have them. So when they hit a low, they just silently disappear. And these people will crumble under the pain of a loss, which is weird if you ask me. Like, okay, there are losses that really hurt, like breakups, they suck. Losing a competition sucks. But here's the thing. You can make it less hard. Because, you see, when most people face a loss, they will make excuses for it. I mean, they convince themselves that the loss wasn't in their control. Like, okay, failed relationship? Okay, my ex is crazy. That's something that they will claim. But I will never do that. Like, I will be like, okay, I did this, this, and this wrong. And if I did that, that, and that, it would have worked. Like, I approach fighting and dating and everything else in the same approach. Like, if it's done, I want to be like, if I could go back in time, I should be able to make it work with the lesson that I learned. If the other person learns the lessons as well. Or I should be able to beat a guy if I go back in time with the things that I learned from a loss. But anyways, people make excuses. And that's the worst thing that you can do. Because you convince people that somebody was lucky, or it was your night, or you just dated the wrong person. And this doesn't work like that. You might fool people with this, but you won't fool smart people. You know? When I lost at the grappling match, I made a mistake. And my opponent took the opportunity. He shot for an armbar, flying armbar. It was really the most sucky armbar that I ever saw. But he tapped me, and that's props to him. Like, I shouldn't have stuck out my arm that was in front. But anyways, the perspective of loss. Loss is a part of life, and you can't grow if you don't lose in life. So, if you have a loss in life and you're making excuses, you're basically wasting a golden opportunity to grow or to get better. Because, really, if you don't improve after a loss, you wasted it big time, because you went through all the emotions, all the pain, and then you do nothing with it. Like, you should internalize that pain. Like, accept it. Just accept it. Look what you did wrong. And then try again. But that's something that I'll cover later. So, after that grappling tournament, I asked my coach, what did I do wrong? And he was like, oh, you did this wrong. And I was like, oh, okay. And then I was in the gym the day after the fight. Like, I didn't care. Like, I can face people even after a loss. I face them head on. I'm like, there's nothing wrong with losing. People treat it like it's a bad thing, but it's not. Like, I was pissed, but it's okay. It's not the event that is bad. It's your perception on the event that it's bad. And that's the thing that most people don't get. So, maybe you should embrace the fact that you're not perfect. Maybe you should accept the fact that you'll face a lot more adversity in life than you want to. Or do you want to keep up with the act and pretend that you're perfect and never make a mistake? You might think that is a sign of strength, but it's not. Being vulnerable is a sign of strength. Like, being able to admit that you fucked up and analyzing your mistakes. Having heart, that's having courage. Like, there is nothing strong about running away from your problems. That's just a sign of weakness. That's a weak-minded thing. So, whenever you face a loss, you accept it, you learn from it, and you try again, of course. Like, why should you stop after a loss? I don't get it. I mean, this is so crazy. Like, just think about the six rules that Arnold Schwarzenegger had. Like, I had this on the on my computer, and I know them, like, I memorized them. It's like Trust yourself. Break the rules. Don't be afraid to fail. Ignore the naysayers. Work like hell and give something back. And the third one is don't be afraid to fail. I mean, we all fail. I can't stress this enough. We all fail. But when we look at people, we never focus on the failures. We only focus on their achievements. Like, there's a great quote about Michael Jordan. He's like, I missed like 9,000 shots in my career. I did this, I feel that this and this. But he's still one of the greatest basketball players of all time. And you know why? Because he kept on pushing. And that's the thing. Like, broken relationship, okay, sucks, but learn your lesson, move on. Lost the tournament, learn your lessons, move on. Got knocked out, well, it sucks, but analyze tape, learn your lesson, and move on. And here we can make a clear difference between winners and losers. Winners will trip, fall, dust themselves off, and move on. After learn the lessons, of course. But the loser will stay down and play the victim. And that's a dangerous mindset. Or blame others, which is even worse. I really hate people like that. Like, oh, my ex is crazy. Oh, my opponent got lucky. Like, what the fuck, dude? What the fuck? How can you live like this? I don't get it. Or, all rich people are lucky. Or, one thing I heard recently, we were talking about the fact that I had a breakup. And people were like, are you okay? And I was like, yeah, I just accepted it and learned my lessons. And people were like, oh, you're so lucky. You've got everything figured out. And I was like, how the fuck can I have everything figured out? I had pain as well. I cried as well. Like, it wasn't easy. But I accepted it. And that's the thing. You have to learn to accept things. If you're constantly trying to change something, then you can't accept it. And if you can't accept it, you can't learn from it. And people neglect this all the time. Like, remember this word, acceptance. It's huge. Like, so yeah, I had to accept a lot of pain this year, more than I wanted to, but it's actually a good year. Now that I look back on it, I haven't achieved a single goal that I had set out this year. So I want to fight twice. I want to meet the woman of my dreams. And I went to sell 365 ebooks. So fighting twice won't happen anymore. Like, I'm not going to fight anymore this year. That's a fact. Meeting the woman of my dreams? That's possible. I mean, I still have 10 days, but I don't know. No, the holidays are coming and I think I'm going to focus on family and friends now, which might be a good thing. Selling 365 ebooks is still possible, but I only sold a handful so far, so I don't know. It was hard, you know, to look back on the year and kind of see it as a loss. But I accepted it and I learned my lessons. You know, like, I could have fought twice this year. It would have been easy, but I had to change camps earlier. Meeting one of my dreams? Possible. You know, you have 365 days in a year, and the girl that I dated was great and a lot of fun, but it just didn't work out. So, you know, I'll meet someone else who's great. And then the ebooks would have been possible as well, especially now that I have my mentor. So I think that's it, you know. I just think that people should accept losses a lot quicker, whatever it is. It's like I said, you'll face a lot more loss in life. You know, you'll face loss because family members will die, friends will die. You'll face periods of pain in relationships. But those are the ones that make the relationship grow. You know, there are so many things. It's just the cycles of life, you know. It hurts, but it's good because we can grow from a loss if we accept it. So that's it for today. I'm going to enjoy my birthday. Hope you have a nice day. Enjoy the holidays, because I don't think that I'll release a podcast on Monday. So enjoy Christmas, enjoy New Year's Eve. Don't get too wasted. And yeah, that's it. Take care. Don't forget to check out my book. I've written a book like a year ago where I shared a lot of life lessons and beliefs that I learned over the course of a year that really helped to change my life. Aside from that, I'm teamed up with Amazon. You can get a free audiobook and a 30-day trial. It's also in the link here below. Don't forget to subscribe and give me a 5-star rating on iTunes. I would really appreciate it. So yeah, that's all. Take care.